ground to develop a tram. Looking at this, it always seems to be, the rule seems to, we are like, we're of the population that we've got about people who are developing. We have developers, we take it on a case by case basis. But when we're looking at developing housing blocks without social housing in it, without any increase in the community level stuff, we've got roads that don't exist, picking up to take these things, we've got cottage surgeries which you've got to wait weeks for an appointment for, we've got schools that are at capacity, we've got no SEN schools that you can send children to, and yet we're quite happy for developers to make their money, make their profits, and put in 4 and 5 bedroom houses that nobody can afford to live here in the middle, to get families in from exterior who will be travelling to Manchester and Liverpool to work in, to afford these places, to spend their income elsewhere. I don't see the issue about why we're not saying to these developers, if you want to build a school in 50 houses in the middle of a housing estate, let's get some money to put into to develop or to increase the capacity in doctor's surgeries. They're going to need doctor's surgeries, school places, which we don't do. That's what the CIL does. This is completely different to 106.
As well as a 14% affordable housing content.
I started this conversation by saying, as you said, Steve, in the planning, we looked on a case-by-case basis. But we seem to have a situation where every case, we don't go to CIL, and we certainly don't go to 106 at the right level. So that's what I'm saying. My proposal, by the way, is that we add this to the workshop that we've already agreed we're going to do on the other. Those are the motion, I want to see what's happening.
Thanks.
That's okay.
Yeah, I mean, it's just a question, really. I do remember about 10, 12 years ago when they were building a house on Warden Road, even though it wasn't in the Warden now. There some negotiations with the builders, and we ended up with actually in Upton. Because it's actually in Warden, they're just over the bridge from Upton and on Manor Drive. Got a new changing facilities built there by the builder, and they did all the drainage of the football pitches as well. Now, I always thought, was that discretionary or whatever? We've just recently, where we're still having to build about 140 houses being built, I thought it was in Upton. After lots of discussion, we found it was in Greasby, but it's on Arrow Park Road, just behind Sainsbury's and that, just the new. And I understand, I haven't been there for a number of months because obviously it's part of Greasby, I'm not talking about it, but they are actually building a new scout hut there as part of the that's what they told me at the time. I haven't been able to see that since. So, I'm just wondering, is this discretionary or is this negotiations that we do with these builders? So there are little things that happen, but then equally, there's a new build, it sounds like it's all happening in Upton with our towns, along Manor Drive, just again past the bridge, they're building another 150 or 60 houses in land that is there. But I don't think they're actually giving anything back into the community. It's still in Morton, although it's on Manor Drive, it's part of the Morton. So my question is this all discretionary, or do builders just come up with these ideas, or whatever?
I'll just try and give you an answer to that. I mean, the specific site behind Sainsbury's,
yes,
you may be aware that there's already existing scaffolds and facilities there. I think it's part of the access arrangements and. There was different land ownerships, so to actually get the scheme to go ahead and pull all the land together, the developer did a deal with the landowner, which was to provide the new scout hut, and then they got ahead. So that was a deal. Those types of deals are done all the time between developers and landowners around that. I mean, the way that we would look at a development is when we're assessing that, you know, clearly there's a number of things, affordable housing, which we spoke about tonight, is important. We look at whether there's any impact on the local highway network, junction improvements, traffic signals needed, and those types of things. And if we believe that there are indeed the same, the Anselmians application that members considered, I think it was last week, was it now? Because where it was in Easton, out of that, we said that we wanted £25,000 to improve the road network by putting 20-mile-an-hour zones in and signs and those things. Those are negotiated and part of a Section 106 agreement because they relate to the development in the site. So there's a number of different ways of doing it, but what we do try and do is maximise, you know, those benefits where we can through Section 106, where those works are absolutely needed to facilitate development.
About 22 years ago, I think you were there, Steve. In this room was a developer that was doing some houses in New Ferry, Rock Ferry. He actually built a park for about 20,000 quid, but he wasn't told to do it. He said he would do it for the benefit of the community because he was that poor to get my application. Don't remember it, so it's not a new thing. It's been going on all the time. Yeah. But I still think we need to entice the developers to build before the
year. Yeah, there are a number of developers. I think one of the ones Tony spoke about, they said they wouldn't be able to, they didn't want to market the site affordable housing or commuted a sum of money to enable the authority to encourage affordable housing elsewhere. There's 101 ways to scan cast. So I think, I'm beginning to think Chris got the right idea that we roll these two together. Because they would actually be, in some cases, be competing with each other. If that small group, and I'd be interested in being on that group as well, Chair, but sort of in planning that we look at it around and try and do a piece of work that is useful to the debate around the local plan. But we get shouted at by Salad, by Phil Gilchrist.
I'll have Councillor Gilchrist, I'd like to apply for Jimmy.
Oh, thank you very much, Chair. Actually, you look at Cheshire Inspector's report, yeah. Looks at areas, it looks at, in fact, the relationship to costs across different sites, quite different from the Lenshul and the Centre of Wales report, for example. Yeah. So that detailed work is the kind of work I think our officers will really get their teeth into in order to help develop our borough.
Okay, so
we've got
a proposal from Chris. Could you
repeat
that?
We can take this on board with the one that we're going to do, the task and finish group that we're going to do with the student colleagues there.
Your second?
I second.
Yeah, okay. So everyone in favour of that?
Yeah.
Agreed. Yeah. Agreed. Okay. Thanks for having me.
Might be useful to two issues that we're debating that. We have someone from the planning department and an elected member or two from the planning committee, possibly the chair. I know they're not a policy making organisation, but it might be useful in what to that group. Well, if they're allowed to go on their groups. Well, I'll be going on and I'm on the
planning. You're on the planning, you should have been
there for a while. We can look into getting us a grant as part of work.
That's a work group for youth development plans.
On screen 4, I don't think March 2018 is realistic. Because, on 3.4, I don't think March 2018 is realistic. And given that we originally wanted to put something in place for councils, which is up to actually going forward to a large extent, what we were changing our focus to, I felt at the last meeting, was looking to how each department of the authority perceived this problem, if at all, and how they dealt with it, so that we could have an awareness-raising exercise, because that would be the only way of doing something useful other than the plans in place. And March gives us no time at all. March we don't really get to grips with what we're going to do and how we're going to do it from now on.
I'd like to do is have a meeting where we can actually see where we're up to, because it's been so long since we've addressed this issue and had a meeting on this thing. I'd like to get together with everybody who's involved, because things have changed since the last time we've done that. There's other things added now. So I think we should have a meeting together so we can ascertain where we are and where we're going. So we'll catch up meeting if you like.
Yeah.
It's been so long since we've addressed this situation, so everybody's happy with that. Our professional levels.
So the amount of staff fit in the
Patrick
wants to
be there.
He's there
to us. Yeah. If we leave the Patrick, we'll go to Patrick, yeah. Okay. Have any questions about any other business?
Just very briefly, Chair. Single-use plastics. So it raises the question, how do members want to take that forward? So if everyone's in agreement, officers come back with a full report next time, and it will pick up on some of the issues around supermarket food, over the cups, water fountains.
Where are our council providing us with single-use plastics?
Recyclable.
Okay, we've had a little Christmas, so thank you, members. Thank you.